Welcome to the Insite WebAdvisor portal registration tutorial. This video is designed to teach you how to register for classes using the portal as well as accessing some other portal features. You will need to have your login information, which includes your portal login and password. Generally, your login will be your first initial, last name, and the last three digits of your student ID number. Generally, your password will be the six-digit birth date. In this case, for example, if your birth date was January 1st, 1980, it would be 010180. You will receive this information via email after you complete your admissions application. Generally, this will become active 24 hours after you receive the email. To log into the portal, you will need to click on the Insite WebAdvisor graphic located on your college's homepage. This will advance you to the pre-login page that you are viewing now, which gives you several ways of accessing the portal. That includes the link on the left-hand side of the page, the graphic in the top center of the page, and the text link below the graphic. If you're having difficulty logging in due to username or password issues, please follow the instructions under the How to Log In to Insite Portal heading. Also, please note that during a peak period such as registration and the beginning of school, the system may respond more slowly than normal. Please be patient. Once you log in, you will be brought to the personalized homepage of the portal. From this page, you can check your Insite email, set up email forwarding to have your Insite mail sent directly to your personal email address, access WebAdvisor to make transactions with the college, view your class schedule, and access your college's website. For now, we will explore the WebAdvisor feature by clicking on the WebAdvisor link. When you click on the WebAdvisor link, you will be brought to a page that looks like the one you're viewing now. To the left, you will see a menu of options. For now, we're going to access the registration menu in order to register for classes. One important link on the registration menu is the My Priority Registration Dates menu. Here you can view the date and time that you can start registering for future terms. We strongly suggest that you begin registering at the date and time listed so as to have the best chance of registering for the courses you want. You have a variety of different ways of searching for and registering for courses. Under the Search for Sections menu, you can look for sections using a variety of filtration options such as subject, course number, meeting days, courses meeting before or after various times, and even instructor last name. You cannot register from this search menu, however. To search, you would click on a location. You could select a term. If you're looking for, say, a short-term course, a course that starts later in the term, you can put that information here. You can also indicate a course subject. So in this case, we'll go ahead and look for an English course, just as an example. You could put, if you want to look at all English courses for Diablo Valley College for fall, you could leave the course number blank, or you could specify a course. So in this case, we'll go ahead and put English 122. And if you know you want to take a course before or after a specific time, you can also put that information in. In this case, we'll go ahead and put in 4 p.m. Once you click Submit, it will bring up the courses listed for English 122 that fall into that category. Here you can view a prerequisite for a course. If you click on the link under Section Name and Title, you can see where the course will be meeting and what time. You can see who is teaching the course, the number of available seats, what the cap is for the course, if there's any wait lists for the course, and then whether or not the course is open, closed, waitlisted, or waitlist closed. If you know of a specific course section that you would like to register for, you can use the Express Registration menu to enter in the section number and term to have that particular section added to your preferred sections list. In this case, you would be putting in the section number just like that, then the term, and then clicking Submit, which would add that to your preferred sections list. Please note that your preferred sections list is a list of courses that you intend to register for but have not yet registered for. More to come on that. Under the Search and Register menu, you can actively search for sections and then register for them. This search feature works similarly to the search menu we just reviewed, but includes the ability to add found courses into your preferred sections list. So we'll run a similar search to what we did before. We're going to go ahead and look for English 122. And then we're going to go ahead and select times meeting after 4 p.m. to run that same search that we did before. The main difference that you're going to see when this comes up is before, this select checkbox here was not listed under the search for sections menu. By selecting that, and I can then submit and have that course added to my preferred sections list. And you will see one that I had added previously as well. Remember, just because a course is in a preferred sections list does not yet mean that you are registered for that course. Finally, if you have attempted to add a course and the instructor has been willing to give you a late add code, you can use the late registration menu to add this course. Here you will list the section number of the course you are attempting to add, the add code that you were given by the instructor, and indicate the term for that particular course. You will then click Submit, which will once again add that course to your preferred sections list. Once you have courses added to your preferred section list from either of the previously mentioned registration options, you must then select Register from the drop-down menu presented in the preferred sections list. So here, we'll go to Register for Previously Selected Sections. And you will see the two courses I had previously selected. So here I would then click on Register for both of those if I was ready to go. I'd need to make sure, of course, that those courses are available. If they were waitlisted, instead of selecting Register, I might select Waitlist. Finally, to finish that action, you would need to click Submit. It will then show you, and I can't show you in this case because I can't register at this time, but it would then show you that you whether or not you have registered for those courses. It is always strongly recommended that once you do that, that you click on My Class Schedule to see which courses you are currently registered for to ensure that it went through properly. Please be aware that if you waitlist yourself, that you will not be able to register for another course during that period of time for which the course that you have waitlisted meets. You will be notified via your Insite email if a seat becomes available in the waitlisted course. Note that you will have a limited amount of time to register for the course once you are notified, so it is important that if you are waitlisted for a course, that you go ahead and check your email frequently to make sure you don't miss that window.